Cardinals, Steelers, coming up on EA Sports. We welcome you to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania for today's game.
The running back position today, manned by a couple of stars of the sport. What are you looking for here?
Yeah, it's kind of refreshing, isn't it, to do a game where it's all about the running backs, meant to talk about the how good the quarterback is and aren't they special? Well, these two running backs are special, and we see it each week how they play, but also we see it how the offenses are designed. It is around the running backs.
The Steelers defense now is going to go nickel. First down at the 21. Andre Ellington with the reception.
Nobody cares. Just get the job done. Throw it deep down the field or throw it short to the running back and look at those extra yards after the short pass.
It's first down as they head to the line. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Incomplete, almost going in the other direction. He is one of the most versatile players in the league, Andre Ellington.
Well, you're right, he is versatile, but I'll also say this, he's really fast, and that's a good attribute to have when you're talking about running backs in the NFL.
Carson Palmer takes a look down from under center. The reception by John Brown. This play set up by the long gainer. Ellington's going to secure the handoff. Second down here. Ellington's handed the football. Gains 12.
Ellington's a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
Back to the ground. Ellington is tackled down. Play number 6 coming up on this drive.
Look at the defensive linemen talking. They're all now shifting to the left.
It's intercepted! Tackle's made.
Shazier is able to show off those great hands and picking off that pass from the linebacker position. What a job and what a pair of hands.
Almost to the 40 at the 39-yard line.
Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
Makes the play.
It's one thing to be able to throw the football that high and far, but it's another. He found the right receiver to throw to and put it right on the mark.
First and 10. Tosses the football. Peterson's all over the ball carrier. What a catch. Touchdown. That's a big way to get the momentum in your favor with that touchdown, Phil.
Yeah, nothing like it. Midway through the first quarter, you're on top of the other team, and you just feel like, hey, we got things under control, and you're putting pressure on the opposition to go out there and try to make something happen.
Johnson's going to test the coverage this time. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line.
The Cardinals offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
Shazier's the one who made the big stop. Second down and 12. Carson Palmer throws the long pass.
Carson Palmer a lot like Phillip Rivers, just has great touch on the long passes. He's a big guy, and he makes those throws look easy.
First down and 10. And he's thrown to the ground.
Outside linebackers who can get to the quarterback, they are a rare breed in the NFL because it takes talent, size, speed, everything to do it as a linebacker, and we saw it that time on display.
The Cardinals at the line of scrimmage, split backfield. The Steelers will come out in the dime from the gun. Michael Floyd hauls it in. Third down now. Ellington on the screen. Allen's going to make the tackle.
Jim, years ago, you never would have seen a screen pass on third down. But offenses are so varied now, you see it more and more. That was nice execution on that play, and it picked up a first down.
Gresham's taken down at the 18. It's second down and 3. Makes the catch in the open field.
First down by the offense in the red zone. And, you know, if you're on the defensive side, you don't have to worry about deep passes anymore. You can be more aggressive and take some chances.
First down, offense readying for the snap. First down here after the completion. Intercepted. Tackle's made. A great play by the defense, and now an opportunity to make that lead a little more comfortable before heading to the second quarter, Phil.
Yeah, you know what they're doing, Jim. They're giving the team confidence, and when you get confident on the football field, you play fast and loose, and that's when you're at your best.
Here's the handoff. And they are in on Bell.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
It's been all about the defenses today as we welcome you back to the action. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Bell's met at the 16. That last play was a run. Third down coming up. That time.
The Steelers will second guess that play call. That time on third short, they throw the football. Everybody thought they were going to run it. They were trying to be too clever, and it backfired. Now it's fourth down.
The Steelers believe they can pick up the first in this short yardage situation and keep the offense on the field. Keeps it pushing ahead. The Cardinals defense not able to make the stop there, and they'll have to stay on the field a little bit longer.
Well, sometimes when it's fourth and short, the toughest man wins, and that time the defense was not the toughest unit.
First and 10 gets the handle here. And they are in on Bell.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the block very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
The Cardinals sat at the line. Dime package. First down at the 30. Toss to the outside. Bell's met at the 30. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day. That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9.
Quarterback has a strong arm, but I am starting to question his touch. Need a little more touch on those deep passes. That time he overthrows the receiver.
The Steelers will take the snap from the 30. They go screen with Williams. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. The Steelers will go for it here on fourth down and a short yardage situation. The Steelers have it at the 39. Toss play here to Williams. The Cardinals defense has to be demoralized by that fourth down conversion allowed.
I think any time on the defensive side when you give up a fourth down conversion, it is heartbreaking, and it has to be heartbreaking for the defense right now.
Halfway through the second quarter, he climbs the ladder and has it. That's his first reception today.
That time, it was an easy completion for the quarterback on the play-action pass, and it fools the defense because look how aggressive the offensive line is. They sold the play to the defense, and the quarterback took advantage.
Touchdown! Steelers put six on the board.
They continue to add to their lead, Phil, late in the second quarter, and so far, there's been no looking back.
Yeah, it's all working on the offensive side, and listen, don't take this for granted. Stay aggressive. Keep putting keep throwing that gas on the fire, pedal to the metal. Whatever cliche you want to use, use it and keep the pressure on.
And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line.
The Cardinals are set to take the field again on offense after a crazy sequence that didn't go their way. That turnover led to turnover points. And now let's see if the offense can get that back, Phil.
Yeah, listen, I know they're going to be motivated because after they turned the football over last time, the coaches took them to the sideline and just gave them heck, that's for sure. That's a good way of seeing it. So motivation, can't make those kind of mistakes. You got to go out there and be much better.
And we've reached the two-minute warning. Second and one on the way.
When you see linebackers shifting around like this, what they're trying to do, confuse the quarterback.
And Gaze there to make the tackle.
What's the old expression? Just move the chains. That's what they did with that throw and catch that time, Jim. It also gives them a chance for three more downs.
Now first and 10. Looking wrong. Almost intercepted.
What a good job by the defensive back that time. That ball was thrown beautifully down the field. High arcing throw, but the defensive back in great position knocks it down.
Second down after the incompletion. The Steelers with a nickel look here on defense. Ellington's got it on the screen. He is brought down at the 49-yard line. Now looking at third down. The Cardinals have to get to the 41 for a first. Gresham's got it on the handoff.
Trying to catch the defense by surprise here on third and long. They go with a run. And sometimes those runs on third and long work that you can pick up a first down. But that time the defense is ready. They tried it, and it didn't work.
Floyd's got it, and a first.
The Cardinals took a big gamble going for it on fourth down, and they got it. Now can you take advantage of that big gamble?
Coming. First down at the 35. It's wide open. A foot touchdown.
There is nothing like getting the long running play for a touchdown. When you do, you just feel like you're stealing something. It takes good blocks, but most importantly, it takes a talented running back to get it done, and this team definitely has one.
So a roughing the kicker call, that could be a game changer here. How about it?
Oh, it is a game changer. It's just not only you get the football back, you get better field position. Now you can score a touchdown. Just a foul that you can't do in a game like this.
There's a flag right there. The kicker just couldn't keep it in bounds there. the Cardinals with two extra defensive backs in the dime. The Steelers will take the snap from the 25. And it's now second down and five after running it on first down.
Not surprised at all to see this hurry up offense in a situation like this. In the NFL now, you got to be the aggressor, and this offense is definitely being the aggressor.
And it's batted down. The offense now needs to pick up the first here on third down after that incompletion. The Steelers need to get to the 35 to pick up. Bryant's got it on a pass that had some heat.
Jim, a good decision here by the coaches to go into hurry-up offense right before halftime. You want to get as many plays off as you can before the halftime whistle blows. Got to give this secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
Failing to complete that one. So second down here. The Cardinals defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. It's wide open. He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day.
Good job that time by the ball carrier, picking up what he can, and he is very smart. Gets out of bounds and stop the clock.
After the long gain, let's see what they do here. And it's caught by Miller. Miller's marked down at the 19. The Steelers signal for a timeout. They have two remaining. 36-yard field goal attempt coming up. The kick is good. We've reached the intermission. And soon we'll be sending you to Larry Ridley, who's going to break down all the first half highlights as we send it to Orlando in a moment. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Catches it at the six and begins the return. And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30. The Steelers really have this offense cranking, Phil. They scored on their last two series.
You know what we see now in the NFL, so many different ways to move an offense. Screens, run plays, power plays, trick plays. Right now, everything working on the offensive side.
The Steelers have it at the 29. He's now over 50 yards rushing on the day.
Nothing like a running back who fights for every extra yard. When you get that extra yard or two, what it does, it just creates better situations for your offense.
Second down, three to go. Launches it down the field, and it's incomplete.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position, nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
The Cardinals go with the dime formation here on defense. They're going to run it on the toss.
Bell's looking for a place to run the football that time to pick up the third down and short, but nowhere to go. Offensive line gets dominated. Now it's fourth down.
The offense is going to stay on the field now for this fourth and seven. Bell takes his spot in the backfield.
Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
And intercepted. They bring him to the turf.
Linebackers nowadays are so talented. They can just do everything. They're strong enough to stop the run. But how about this interception? Good job. Good reading of the quarterback and a nice catch. Well, the defensive line noticed something. They're all shifting to the left. Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Ellington's going to take the handoff now. Gains 14.
Jim, when you're down multiple scores in the second half, you're looking for the little things to get momentum on your side. So just get a first down. Don't look for the big plays. That was a good job by the offense that time.
First and goal from the eight. makes the catch in the end zone. Touchdown.
How important was that score, Phil? Facing a big deficit and suddenly scoring a touchdown, and things look a whole lot different.
Well, it was great. It was great. What a job to find a way to score that touchdown. And now the coach has got to look at the scoreboard and start thinking of a different strategy since this game has gotten close.
And he's going to be brought down right around the 33-yard line.
The Steelers offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
Second down now.
The Cardinals come out in a dime package.
Halfback sent in motion. Bell's taking the handoff. Campbell's able to read that play and make the hit. The Steelers will use a timeout here early in the second half. It's third down coming up.
Roethlisberger comes out in the pistol.
Locked in on the football and hat
on his way.
The 10, taking it all the way home for the touchdown.
And they continue to take that game plan that worked so well in the first half and add to it here midway through the third quarter with another touchdown, Phil.
So my answer is, what's the defense thinking? My gosh, the game plan didn't change on the offensive side, but you had no answers for it. Time to get on that sideline and figure out what you want to do.
Johnson's going to run this one out. And the tackle is made right around the 26-yard line. The Cardinals offense ready to continue its recent run here as they've scored the last two times they've had it, Phil.
Well, let's look at it from the defensive side. What do you think they're thinking? Oh, my gosh, what's coming next? Because everything the offense has tried so far has worked.
And that gains a few.
Ellington's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
Second and seven on the way. The Steelers lined up in the nickel. The Cardinals have it at the 29. Going deep. Wow, what a catch. That's his third catch of the day. How about how high he went up in the air to get that one?
Unbelievable job that time. And again, that's part of every offense now in the NFL. It wasn't like that when I played. We didn't have guys that could go up and make catches like that.
Second down after going to the ground game, the first play. They're going to the hurry. They want to keep feeding him the football. And he's tackled down after picking up the first. First and 10. Back to him. Ellington's tackled down at the 22. Should have been caught.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
Third and six coming up.
The D-lines, they're seeing something on the offensive side. Everybody shifting to the left.
Makes the reception.
What a nice catch by the receiver. Getting past the yard markers, makes the catch, and gets a first down. Good job by the offense getting in the red zone. Now you're down some points. You got to find a way to score a touchdown.
Palmer standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Touchdown, and this game is tight.
Still more than a quarter left in the game, and with that touchdown, they're well within striking distance.
Oh, they're right there now. Now you can sit back and change what you were trying to do. You don't have to play with desperation. You got it. Now what you've done by scoring, you've made the other team have to come out and play and take some chances.
To move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Steelers now march to the line. Tightly contested game here in the fourth. The score is 24 to 21. He'll take the snap, the first here in the fourth quarter. Le'Veon Bell makes the catch. Peterson that time on the tackle. The Steelers have created chances for themselves in the passing attack today. Roethlisberger's had a huge performance in this one.
When you talk about creating opportunities, that's where you have to give credit to the coaching staff. They have helped the players. The play designs have been good, and the players are taking advantage of it. The Steelers' offense, they know it's more than just about their defense. The offense did a good job that time picking up the first down. That's what you want to do. You got a small lead in the second half. Keep getting those first downs and eat that clock up.
And he's taken down.
The offensive coordinator's just got to make some adjustments here. They can't stop the defensive line from sacking the quarterback, so either keep the tight end in or keep the halfback in to help block for the QB.
Loss of two on that play. Jumps high and comes down with it. That's his fourth catch of the day. The Steelers have come up with some big plays in the passing game. Bryant's had big plays all over this field today, Phil.
He's like the shooting guard, Jim, in basketball. If he's making a lot of shots, let him keep shooting. So they have found a way, keep getting the football in his hands.
First down following the long play. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
First down at the 24. Greeny brings the quarterback down.
It is truly a bonus when you can take your outside linebacker and let him rush the quarterback, and he can get a sack. Nice job that time by the outside linebacker.
Set up now at the 32. If they're going to have any chance at all here late in the fourth, the defense must make a big stop and give the ball back to the offense. On the way, third down. We've hit the 2-minute warning in the second half. The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. And Williams is lined up as the single back.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
They bring back out the offense to go for it. Crucial play here. Fourth down on the way. Snags it right out of the air with one hand.
I don't know if I agree with that call going for it on fourth down here in the second half when you got a little lead, but the coach is confident. They go for it on fourth down. They pick it up, and that keeps the drive going.
About to snap it for the ninth play of the drive. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Bell, right side. This has been a long drive. The Cardinals will come out in the dime. Second and goal from the 8. And they are... Bell.
snap it now at the 7-yard line. Third and goal from the 7. Toss to the outside. He'll pick up 7 this time.
The defense has to know the situation here. They know if they give up a touchdown, the game is over. So you play run all the way, be very aggressive, and try to stop it.
Now or never, fourth and goal. They'll go for it on fourth down, late stages. Touchdown as we near the end of this one.
That time on fourth and goal, the offense goes for it. The defense is all excited. They want to try to stop them, and they make bad mistakes and give up the touchdown.
The Cardinals are ready to return the kickoff. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Cardinals' offense still has a chance here, Phil. Late in the game, can they make something happen?
Well, it's going to be interesting to see, Jim. I think let's look at it from the defensive side. Know the situation. If they get the ball, they catch a pass, make sure you come up and make the tackle. Don't let them catch and run and get a big play against you. Well, sometimes when you have a talented receiver, you just got to put up with plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, they can make a big play.
Second down coming up. Time, obviously, a factor the rest of the way. Just about a minute left. It would take a miracle to pull this one out. Brown's there to catch a ball that had a lot of heat on it. The Cardinals signal for the timeout, and they have none remaining. First down. Pressure on every snap now. The Steelers set at the line. Dime package. The Cardinals take it from the 43. Complete to Floyd. And now they'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play.
I think what you find out about your offensive lineman, what kind of shape you're in here. It's late in the game. You have no timeouts. You got to go to this hurry-up offense. Let's see if they can make it work. This is why teams are always practicing a two-minute offense for situations just like this. You have the football, under 2 minutes to go. You're losing. You pick up some good yards, and your player is smart enough to get out of bounds and stop the clock.
Palmer's now completed 4 in a row. Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way. First down and 10. Looking across the middle, and the pass is intercepted. It's going the other way, and this game is all but over. Offense comes out for what is in essence just a kneel down or two to make this one official. And Phil, what a sweet moment it is for that bunch of players right there.
Oh yeah, a lot of smiles on the offensive side as you walk out on the field. And it's just, you think about it this way, a tough week of work, all the preparation and the practice, and you came through and got it done, and enjoy the moment.
First down here after the completion. They go screen with Bell. Rocked for a loss on that tackle. The Steelers are going to use one of the two timeouts they have remaining. This will be the final snap. Second and 12. Knocked down as he fires it. Well, Phil, I enjoyed watching the game with you, and how about a final thought about that victory?
Well, you know, Jim, I wish I could say the same, that I enjoyed spending these last 3 hours with you, but that's just not the case. But, no, just kidding, of course. Nice win. They got to feel good about what they've done and celebrate a little tonight.
I think I'll see you next week, maybe.